Okay, class, we talked to you about planting a citrus tree, so now we're going to do a little demonstration. What we have here is a kumquat tree, and this is the sour kumquat. And I want to thank Star Nursery for making the donation to us so that we could do this little video for you. So now I'm going to go ahead and plant this kumquat tree here in the yard, and you can see everything that actually goes into planting a citrus tree. Now, the first thing we talked to you about was site selection. That's the most important thing. So right here where I've chosen to put this tree, the sun, this is running east and west. So it's going to get morning sun. It's going to get at least 6 hours. Actually, it's going to probably get closer to 8 to 10 hours of sunlight here. And on the back side here, there are some shrubs, and those are gardenias. And if they get bigger, they might start to shade the tree a little bit. However, because it's facing this way and getting that good morning sun, that's not going to be a big problem if this area starts to be shady at some point. So it's going to get at least 6 to 8 hours of sun. Now, I did a soil test. I know I got plenty of nutrients in there right now. The pH is pretty good for my citrus tree, and it's got excellent drainage. So with the organic matter, the nutrients, and the good drainage, this would be an ideal site to plant my citrus tree. Now you can see yesterday, it looks a little dry on top, but if you dig down a little, you see it's moist. And we told you that we recommend that you water your tree the day before you plant it. Now some people may wonder, why are you watering the tree the day before you plant it? Why is that such a big deal? Well, if you do that, then one thing you're going to know for sure is that your tree is not suffering from water stress. Because if you water it the day before, it has plenty of time to take up that water you put in there, and the tree will be nice and healthy. It won't be suffering any water stress at all. Another reason is, whenever you're planting your tree, you want to make sure that the soil stays attached to the roots as much as possible. You really don't want to disturb the soil on the roots. And so by watering it, now that moist soil is going to clean and make more of a root ball when you take your plant out to plant it. Now, we told you that you don't want to plant the plant any deeper than the soil level that it is in the pot. Now, you can go through it and you can get a measuring stick and measure it and know the inches and everything. But you can just take a stake that you have in the yard and figure it out. Okay, if I plant this tree right there, I got a little joint on my bamboo stake, so I'm going to dig my hole no deeper than right here, because you don't want to plant it deeper than the soil level in the pot. Also, if you'll notice, we told you to identify your graft line. So right here is the graft union for my kumquat tree. This is the rootstock. This is the scion. So this is the part that I like because of what it's going to produce. This is the part I like because of the good healthy roots. Now this one I got at a nursery, and it's pretty good shape. But you see right here, that's a little bit of a stub left when it was pruned. Now we don't like stubs. Stubs are an invitation for insects and disease. So before I even start digging my hole, I'm going to go ahead and take those stubs off. I didn't cut into where the healing part of the branch collar, where the healing part of the plant is. So now those stubs are gone. So it's going to be a healthier plant because they're out of the way. Now I'm going to go ahead and go through the digging process and planting of the tree. So I know where I want it to be, right there. And you can see this is already a mulched area, so I'm going to remove the mulch, get it out of the way. And remember, we said dig the hole about 2 to 3 times the size of your pot. So now we're going to go ahead and dig the hole, and we're going to save the soil that will come out of here, because that's what goes back in. That's our backfill. So I'm going to go ahead and put it into the wheelbarrow, and then it'll be easy to put it back into the hole when I plant the tree. So now I've got my hole dug to about the perfect depth. So you can see when the plant is sitting in here, the level that the soil is in the pot is going to be the same as ground level here. So now I got my hole ready. Now we want to remove the tree from the pot. So kind of loosen it up a little. And some of the soil falls out, that's okay. And then you want to remove it. And you want to examine the roots. Now this one is really nice because as you can see, the roots are out, they're just touching the edge of the pot, but they're still real loose, still nice and small. They haven't started to make girdling roots. Now here's one that's a little bit big. So that one, I'll loosen it up a little bit. So this is starting to circle. We don't want that to happen. So with this one being the way it is, now in order not to disturb the root ball too much, I'm going to go ahead and cut this root and remove it. It would probably have been fine if I hadn't done that, but as long as I'm planting it and I want it to look really good, why not? Now see, this one is not circling, it's going downward, so that one's going to be good. So now go ahead and put the tree into the hole. Now you want to get the tree sitting as straight as possible. Remember when I told you about site selection, you want to make sure that your tree can grow and have plenty of room. Now, a sour kumquat tree can get anywhere from 6 to 12 feet tall and about 6 feet wide. And you can keep it smaller if you want, but just by pruning. So this area that I've chosen, we got a post here, but that's all a good 3 feet from where the trunk will be. So if it gets 6 feet wide, it might just be touching the post, but that's fine. And my height, I got plenty of room for that. So now I'm ready to backfill. And remember, when you backfill, you want to use the same soil that you took out of the hole to backfill. Because if you add fertilizer and real rich amendments to the soil and then backfill it, sometimes they found that the roots will grow out into that area. And then when it reaches the side of the hole, the roots don't want to go into that. So it can actually slow down your tree and make it less healthy. So go ahead and backfill with the same soil you took out. We won't be doing any fertilizing for at least 6 weeks. Here, that nub is still a little bit too big. See how it's sticking up? So it's easy for me with my little pruner just to reach in there and nip that off. Now I've gotten rid of that nub. This is the scaffolding I'm going to eventually use for the shape of the tree. This I'm just leaving for the first year so that it can provide nutrients to the tree. I mean, the leaves are still going to be photosynthetic, so they're going to feed the tree and the roots and keep it growing nice. And I'm going to take this one off though because it's crossing. And I don't want it rubbing my trunk here. So there, I got my tree planted. It's in the ground at the proper depth. I watered it in good. I have it mulched. And there's some flower buds starting here. Remember we told you, get rid of the flowers and the fruit that first year. Well, I love the fragrance of citrus flowers, so I'm going to go ahead and let these open. However, once they're open and I've got all the benefit of that beautiful fragrance, I will remove these and not allow them to produce fruit this first year. So, there you are, planting a citrus tree. Choose your proper site location as far as sunshine, as far as soil conditions and drainage, and as far as space that the tree is going to need. Dig your hole, plant your tree, water it in, mulch it, and then just let it grow.